Welcome back, lovers. All right, so today we are talking about the amorous narcissist. Now, I've already covered about the vulnerable and the invulnerable narcissist prior to this video. And so today we are going to talk more about the amorous narcissist. And before I begin, let me just state, this is just an awareness video. This is not to accuse one who may have, you know, this type of disorder. And just basically for you to protect yourself by learning the behaviors and recognizing them if need be. Okay? All right. So the amorous narcissist, we all know someone who is this type, if we're not ourselves. The amorous narcissist is basically the type of individual who seeks out sexual escapades, okay? And for the mere purpose of fulfilling their sexual prowess. And by doing this, it gives them a rise, no pun intended, but they get a rise out of doing this. It boosts the ego. It makes them feel as though they're accomplishing something by taking this sort of, you know, experience away from someone. So what happens is the amorous narcissist, they tend to lure someone in by, you know, flirting and making the person feel desired and wanted and making them feel as though they are this sexual being. Because a lot of times, many people already feel deprived that, you know, hey, I'm not special enough to be desirable, or I'm not as attractive. So this sort of narcissist preys on that type of individual, one who may be emotionally needy or just completely naive. And by preying on them, they kind of allow this person to feed off of them. You know, oh, you're so wonderful. You're so special. You treat me so kind. And it's not really even a relationship. It's just that they are wooing this person so much so that this person becomes like in bliss and in total oblivion just by having sexual encounters with this person. They feel as though it's a very romantic experience that they're having, when in actuality it isn't. This person, this narcissist, comes into their life and makes them feel that there is no other person that can make them feel the way that they do. So at the end of it, each other begin to feel as though, hey, I'm wanted, I'm needed. And the amorous narcissist, he'll play around with this person for a while. And he or she, they'll play around with a person's emotions and make them feel as though they are the special one. And it's just all merely one long drawn out sexual experience, until suddenly, like that of a child, when this narcissist becomes bored and no longer wants to play with the same toy, he or she tosses it aside and grabs one that is new. That's it. There really isn't a whole lot of emotion. If anything, there's emotion on the front of, you know, the pleasure of sex. You know, it's so deceiving, because the person that's on the other end, they're thinking that, hey, they're experiencing, you know, love. And it could come off that way, because listen, this narcissist has been doing this for a very long time and is very skilled at it. So you may think that you're on cloud nine with the greatest person in the world, whereas you're about to be dropped and you're going to plummet. And when you plummet, it's going to be hard. And to say the least, this sort of person, this narcissist, does not just typically have one person that they're doing this with. It's usually like simultaneously. So they're feeding off of it, you know? Yeah. And this is what they do to build themselves up for whatever reason. Okay? So yeah, that's basically all that there is about the amorous narcissist. Like I said, we all know this person. We've all experienced. I mean, I've experienced this person. And this person actually admitted that to me. It's the weirdest thing, but yeah. So just to make you guys aware of who the amorous narcissist is, it could be man or woman, you know. But yeah, and that is all for today. I thank you so much for joining me. Until next time.